Hey guys, it's Hank from Sprues and Brews, and today we've got another video for folks who are just getting into the hobby of scale modeling. We're gonna be looking at 10 essential tools that every scale modeler should have in their toolbox. Now, today I'm not gonna be talking about model kits or paint recommendations. I do have another video for my top 5 beginner kit recommendations, I'll link that here. But in this video, we're gonna be looking at the tools and equipment that you're gonna need to build and paint up your models. These are things that I use every single time I make a kit, and a lot of them I've been using since I first started. These are all good quality pieces that hopefully you're gonna be able to use for a really long time and will help you grow in this hobby. So let's check out these 10 essential tools to help you start your scale modeling journey. I'll have links for all these items in the description below if you wanna check them out afterwards. Make sure you stick around to the end of the video for my number one recommendation. It's a piece of equipment that I think helped take my build to the next level when I first got started and made a huge difference for me. All right, with all that said, let's get into it. All right, so when you're making a scale model, any scale model really, the first thing that you're probably gonna need to do is remove pieces from the sprue. A sprue, for anybody who's just getting into this hobby, is a plastic injection molded sheet that has all of your pieces on it. There's gonna be several of these in each kit depending on the size and complexity of the model, and as the instructions call for it, you're gonna need to cut these individual pieces off to start building the kit. Now to do this, don't twist the pieces off the sprue. It's technically gonna work. You'll be able to remove pieces from the sprue this way, but it's really not good for the parts. So what you're gonna need is a pair of sprue snippers. I've had these little guys for years and they're still serving me just fine. This is actually a really fine wire cutter, but they've been perfect as sprue snips. All you do is you just get the flat edge right up to the piece that you wanna remove and snip away. And it's gonna leave you a nice fine cut that you can just clean up with your blade or with a sanding tool. So my very first recommendation is that you pick up a set of sprue snippers. They're gonna run you like $8 and you're probably gonna have them forever. I've been using these for about 3 years. They're getting a little dull now. I'm probably due for an upgrade, but they're awesome. They're really reliable and this is a great place to start. All right, so sticking with the small tool theme here, my next recommendation would be a nice pair of tweezers. Regardless of whatever kind of kit you're working on, you're gonna be dealing with some small parts. A good pair of tweezers is gonna help you manipulate small parts as you try and get them into place with precision and accuracy. I try and find tweezers that have a really fine tip. When you're dealing with super tiny parts like an antenna wire, you wanna make sure you've got a good grip on there and it's not slipping out all the time. Aside from my regular tweezers, I have a set of crosslock tweezers, and these guys are a real game changer. They're set up differently than your traditional tweezers in that it's the opposite mechanical function. You squeeze to actually open up the tips, and you let go to lock them down. These are great for holding pieces in place for an extended amount of time so you don't have to use your finger strength. Like, I can just pick up my other tweezers here, and I'm not doing anything really, it's holding them fine. So you can imagine with light plastic parts, this is super handy. These are great for decal work because you can just grab right onto the side of the decal sheet, dip them in water, and then after the decal is soaked, you don't have to fish it out of there when it's floating around. It's just gonna be held right on the tweezers already. So these are two great little products to have in your scale modeling toolbox, a regular pair of tweezers and a pair of crosslock tweezers. All right, this next one is one of those bread and butter pieces that every scale modeler has to have in their toolkit. It's a nice craft knife or X-Acto knife or scalpel, whatever you wanna call it. There's a good argument that this is the most used tool of the scale modeler. At least it is for me. You're constantly gonna be cutting in this hobby, whether it's removing extra bits from pieces, trying to trim them down a little bit, cutting decals off the decal sheet, trimming masking tape, you name it, and you've gotta have a good reliable knife. I picked this one up in a set a while ago. It came with two handles and like 60 blades, I think, 60 brand new sharp blades. So you can work with it for a while. When it starts to get dull down, you can just twist it, pop it off and replace it with a new blade. This is the way to do it. You don't need to buy like a new knife, obviously, every time you're working. Get a little kit like this and you're always gonna have a sharp knife whenever you need it. This thing is basically an extension of my hand at this point, but it's definitely an essential tool for every scale modeler. So invest in a good X-Acto knife. All right, next we're gonna talk about modeling surface. So whether you have a dedicated workspace, like a workbench that you use every time, or you have a mobile setup that you kind of set up and break down after each modeling session, you're gonna need a good quality self-healing cutting mat. Now, a cutting mat like this is awesome because it's made out of this composite vinyl material, and if you're cutting something on it, you can cut right into it and it's not gonna scar. That slice is gonna seal right up and you're almost not even gonna know it's there. Because of that, this mat isn't gonna break down very easily and you're gonna be able to use it for a really long time. Mine is two-sided. This side is relatively clean. I've only been using it for a few months now. This side is pretty battle-torn after about a year's worth of stuff. But honestly, it's not too broken down. There's just a few bigger slashes in it, but there's just a lot of masking tape on here because those are the remnants of, I don't know, dozens and dozens of projects. I recommend picking up a big one like this because I think it's better to have more space than be working on like a little 12x12. This is a 24x18, I believe. So definitely recommend picking up a self-healing cutting mat. Great place to work, and it's super important to just have a sturdy, reliable workspace. So grab yourself one of these. All right, this next one is a really simple one, and it's not actually a scale modeling tool by design, but this is an essential for me, and I think it's an essential in most scale modelers' toolboxes. This is a nail file or an emery board. I've been using this small nail file on my builds for years. When you're working on a kit, you're gonna have some parts where you snipped the piece off a sprue and you need to sand down that little bit of extra on there, or you need to sand off a seam line or something like that. And this is generally where I start. I also use some finer grit sandpaper when I need to get into smaller areas, but this is what I'm using 75-80% of the time. Emery boards like this are usually two-sided. One of them's got a slightly more aggressive grit and one of them's got a finer grit, which is perfect. So if you've got a big gnarly piece you need to sand off a kit, you can start with the more aggressive side and then flip over to the finer side to kind of clean it up a little bit. You can find these things all over the place. You could probably run to the nearest convenience store and pick one up in the next 5 minutes if you needed to, but definitely essential. Pick one of these up, you won't regret it. One of the questions that I get asked the most by new scale modelers on Instagram is, what's the right kind of glue for building plastic scale models? My recommendation is always Tamiya Extra Thin Cement. You're gonna have a few exceptions where you'll need super glue, but this is where it's at. It comes in this little bucket and it's got this built-in applicator brush, which is perfect for getting into little areas, and it's super precise. Awesome design all around. This stuff, it's just perfect. You can put a little bit of this stuff on the parts you need to fuse together, and it's actually gonna chemically bond those two plastic pieces. It leaves a crisp, smooth connection together. You're not gonna have any spillover. The brush is perfect because you only put on as much as you need, and it's just, it's a great design. I think this hasn't changed in years, but this is the go-to for cement for plastic models. These little tubs are perfect, and honestly, even if you're cranking out dozens of kits a year, this is gonna last you a while. I think I just picked up this new one, but the last bottle I had, I'd been working on it for almost 2 years, and I probably made 20 or so kits, so this stuff's great. All right, so if duct tape is the fix-it product for everything else in life, Tamiya masking tape is the jack of all trades for scale modeling. It comes in handy little spools and dispensers like this, and you can pick up refills on almost any scale modeling site or even on Amazon. I like the 18 millimeter personally, but it comes in a whole bunch of different widths. There's a ton of different things you can use this for. You can use it to mask off areas of a build so you can replicate certain camouflage patterns. You can use it to mask off the canopies on aircraft models so you can protect those clear plastic parts while you're painting. And you can even use it to make your own DIY straps for weapons and equipment. I use this, you can cut out little slices of it and put it right on your figures on the weapon strap there, or coming off of stowage on your vehicles. It's a nice little touch and super cheap, super easy, scrappy little stuff. I've got a few extra rolls laying around at any given time. You're gonna use more of this stuff than you might expect. So definitely recommend picking up some Tamiya masking tape. All right, so spoiler alert. These last few recommendations are all about the finishing process in this awesome little hobby, i.e. the painting and weathering processes. We're all trying to learn and grow in this hobby, right? So a little patience and extra dedication to the painting and weathering processes of a model are what's gonna help each successive kit that you build be better than your last. That said, it's super important to have a reliable set of paintbrushes at your disposal for finishing your models. Now, these particular paintbrushes won't suffice for painting up a whole model aircraft kit or a tank kit. We'll get into that in a little bit here. But these are perfect for detail work on those bigger builds and for figure painting. I've been using these particular brushes for years now, and I love these little ergonomic grips. These brushes are great quality, and this relatively inexpensive pack comes with a whole bunch of different sizes for whatever level of detail you really need to work on. These are great for weathering too. You can use them with acrylics, you can use them with oils, enamels, you name it. Do yourself a favor. When you're first starting out, don't mess around with low quality brushes. Get yourself something nice in the mid-range there, spend $10, $20 on them, and you're gonna have something really nice that it's not gonna be frustrating, and it's gonna last you a while if you take care of them. This set has been perfect for me, and I highly recommend them. All right, guys, we're getting down to the end here. Now, this one is probably gonna give away what my number one recommendation is, but it's really important that it's on here. We're gonna talk about airbrushing scale models in the next recommendation, but it's really important to protect yourself while you're doing the airbrush work. This is a wonderful hobby, and you gotta be smart about it. So my number two recommendation is a nice respirator. I've been airbrushing for years now, and I always wear my trusty little respirator here when I'm doing my paint work. Even if you're in a well-ventilated area, you're probably gonna have your face right up close to the stuff you're working on, and an airbrush is gonna vaporize the paint and the thinners, enamels, whatever product you're working on. All those particles are gonna be floating in the air, you're gonna be breathing them in. So just protect yourself, protect your lungs, and get yourself a good respirator. Even if you're not using an airbrush and you start out with some rattle cans, some spray paint like I did right when I started, you're still gonna need something like this because you're vaporizing the paint and you're creating an aerosol, and you need to protect your lungs. So it's really not worth breathing in all that crap. So you get one of these, you'll be ready to rock and roll.
Plus, you're gonna look super cool when you're wearing it, and you kind of sound like one of those B-17 crew members. It's like you're an extra in Memphis Belle or something like that. So you know what? Just, I don't know, have fun with it. Protect yourself, be smart, get a respirator.
All right, we made it all the way to number one. And if you didn't guess it from the last recommendation, my overall top recommendation for a new scale modeler getting into the hobby is to invest in a basic airbrush and air compressor setup. When I first started in this hobby, the biggest thing holding me back from developing my skills was not having an airbrush. Pretty much every professional or semi-professional scale modeler out there is finishing their kits, painting their kits with an airbrush. Airbrushing, when done correctly, gives you a smooth, clean application of paint on the surface of your model and opens up so many doors for camouflage and finish schemes. This is a game changer. In the real world, most of these military vehicles would actually be painted with an airbrush, albeit a considerably larger one, but the best way to replicate the real world is to miniaturize it and kind of do the same thing. Now, don't get me wrong, it takes years and years to master an airbrush. I still am learning every single time I paint something. I'm trying to get a little bit better with each build. But the best way to start improving your skills and to practice is to invest in one of these early so you can start working with it. Now, I picked up a little starter kit on Amazon years back. It came with this compressor and this hose and an airbrush very similar to this one. I've since upgraded to a slightly newer model, but this was all I needed to get started. Name brand airbrushes can run you a few $100s if you start looking at Badger and Iwata and stuff. This is just a master airbrush. I think it cost me 30, 40 bucks. The whole early bundle package that I talked about was right around 100, but like I said, I've been using this for 3-4 years now, and it still works perfectly for all my needs. As long as you take care of your airbrush and you clean it after every use, this setup right here is gonna take you a really long way and help you really develop as a scale modeler. So I highly, highly recommend investing in an airbrush setup early when you get started. You're gonna learn so much just by practicing and experimenting with this, and it's gonna help you really grow and hone your skills with each successive kit that you build. So pick one of these up, mess around with it. I can't more highly recommend it. All right, guys, so that's it for me. I really hope you enjoyed this video and hopefully you got some good recommendations out of it. Like I mentioned in the beginning of this video, I do have a separate video to talk about beginner kit recommendations. These are 5 kits I think are great for somebody just getting into the hobby. You can check that out. I'll leave a link in the description below. I'll also have links to all of the products I mentioned today in the description below, so you can check those out afterwards. So thank you so, so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you want to support the channel, you can do so by hitting the like button below, and you can subscribe for more scale modeling content. I try and post something new and fun just about once a week. So until next time, friends, be well, happy building, cheers.